Travel time between Cavite, Cavite and Binian Laguna will be shortened to 45 minutes from the current 1 to 2 hours once the Cavite-Laguna Expressway or CALAX is completed by 2020. Public Works and Highway Secretary Mark Villar and Metro Pacific Investments Chairman Manny Pangilinan led the groundbreaking for the project. The four-lane expressway will pass through residential and industrial locations along Cavite, Imus, General Trias, Dasmariñas, and Silang in Cavite, and Santa Rosa and Binian in Laguna. It will have 8 interchanges and 1 main toll barrier. The proposed maximum toll is 226 pesos. However, DPWH has yet to fully address right-of-way issues of the project.
May bago na po kaming sistema para sa right-of-way, which is lahat po ng bawat project may sariling task force. So ngayon po, mas mabilis ang pag-acquire namin at at least mata-turn over yung right-of-way sa concessionaire sa lalong madaling panahon. Ngayon po, like kalimbawa itong CALAX, kasing malaking porsyento ng right-of-way ang na-acquire na. Kaya makaka-construct sila kaagad. Makikita nyo po, ongoing na yung construction, dito na yung mga equipments, at ganun din sa ibang PPP projects.
CALAX is one of the biggest projects under government's public-private partnership program, valued at 34.5 billion pesos.
It is a big project by any standards. This came out of a bidding process, so there's a rather significant premium that we're paying to build this to the government. So on top of the construction cost, there's a premium.
The Duterte administration's economic managers earlier said government is now more inclined to fund most big-ticket infrastructure projects through official development assistance or ODA loans, while auctioning off the operations and maintenance contract of the projects through the PPP scheme. But Metro Pacific Investments Chairman Manny Pangilinan says the current setup works well for tollways project.
Of course, we prefer kung ano yung method na mabilis. Yun ang importante sa mabilis at hindi, of course, syempre, convenient sa ating mga kababayan. Whatever, but kami naman, open naman kami sa, we have a preference for yung mga hybrid kasi pag hybrid, mas mabilis yung construction.
I think it's their decision. I hope we keep it that way for the tollways. No? And mukhang open naman sila to that idea. At saka, in respect to the existing tollways, either expansion ito, so like NLEX, or extensions lang naman.
Aside from CALAX, Metro Pacific has bagged other big infrastructure projects, such as the Segment 10 Harbor Link that will connect NLEX to R10, the NLEX-SLEX Connector Road, the C5 South Link Project, and the Cebu-Cordova Link Expressway. These projects are expected to ease traffic flow in Metro Manila and Cebu. Jackie Manabat, ABS-CBN News.